ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Studio Art. I'm your instructor, Mr. Schwartz, and in today's lesson, we'll be taking a look at facial features. We'll be doing studies of each of your facial features, and then in the next assignment, we'll be putting them all together to create your self-portrait. Let's get started. So the first thing that I'm going to show you is your assignment and what you're expected to do. So attached to your assignment on Google Classroom, you're going to see tutorials for both the front and side view of each of your facial features. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to be drawing your nose, your mouth, and two different orientations, front and side. Your eyes will be drawn straight on, just one picture with the correct amount of space between them, and then your left and your right ear. Okay, so I'll go over this again in the assignment, but let's take a look at the materials. Okay. So for this, I will always encourage you to start and work with a light blue pencil for construction lines, which are sketches that eventually will become either erased or just not used. You can see that the construction lines here in this picture are the top. If you use a light blue colored pencil, it makes it lighter so you have another layer to work with so you don't start out quite so darkly, but it's completely up to you. And another option is just to sketch lightly. Pencils, I always encourage you to use a range of pencils. There are the H's and the B's. The H's have thin and hard lead for softer and lighter values, whereas the B's are for darker values, and they have a softer lead for blending better. All right, so blending sticks just to smooth out your values. This is optional as well. You can also use your finger, a piece of paper, cloth, whatever will blend it, and you can have the most control. And an eraser, which is more for just erasing construction lines and cleaning up messes. It's also used for creating light areas such as highlights and reflections, which you can see in the eye here. All right. And just to lighten up and smooth out some of your values as well. You can also use your eraser to blend and smooth things as well if you do it light enough. All right, so here is going to be your assignment. So it's everything that I just said. The aim is to master the individual parts of your face and then put them together to create a self-portrait. You're gonna be doing this on your own face. And the way that you can approach this is that you can light your face and just take photographs with your phone, because you can do the flip screen, and that could be a way for you to work from reference and have it be your own. So your assignment one is to draw both of your eyes with the correct amount of space between them. And I always want you to shoot for as much realism and accuracy as possible. So try to place the amount of space. Usually it's the amount of space of one eye in between the eyes. So if you were to draw three eyes in a row and erase the middle one, that would be the correct amount of space. Usually, I'm not saying you should approach it that way, but that would be the correct amount of space. In assignment two, you're going to draw two views of your nose, front and side, on the same page. Assignment three, you're going to draw two views of your lips, front and side, on the same page. Assignment four, draw both your left and your right ear. And of course, these are to be shaded as accurately as you can to the reference that you're drawing from, the picture. Okay, so that's about it. It's pretty straightforward. It tells you what I want on each page and what you're expected to do. So I really look forward to seeing what you come up with. And you can always catch me at office hours or shoot me a question on the Google Stream. And until then, take care.